We're going to do the functional vision head impulse test. This test looks at the patient's vestibular ocular reflex, so how their ears talk to their eyes. It's very similar to how we perform our VHIT test, and actually the placement of the hands is very similar, so I'll show you in just a second. But first, I'm going to instruct the patient. You're going to see an optotype pop up on the screen, and I want you to tell me which direction the optotype is facing, left, up, down, or to the right. If you don't know the answer, you can say, I don't know. And I'm going to be moving his head. We're going to start with the lateral, which is left or right directions, because we're looking at the lateral semicircular canals. So I'm going to place my hands right below his chin, my thumbs right behind his ears, and we're going to do quick head impulses that are randomized left and right directions. So here we go. Very good. And he's seeing the optotype change directions on the screen. Very good. Yep. And I'm inputting the response on the remote. Very good. And if he doesn't know the answer, he can always say, I don't know. I can also just wait out the response on the software. Right. We have a 5 second waiting period. So I don't have to press a button if he doesn't know the answer. I just have to wait 5 seconds. Very good. So while I'm doing this test, I'm getting a lot of information about his vestibular ocular reflex in that horizontal or lateral plane. Good. Very good. We'll do just a couple more. This test looks at a variety of different speeds or frequencies of head movement. So sometimes I'm doing very, very slow head movements, and other times I'm doing quite fast. And it looks at different parts of that VOR. Very good. Nice work. Next, we're going to look at the vertical canals. So there's two pair planes that we look at. The first one is called the left anterior, right posterior, or LARP plane. So you'll put one hand on top of the head, one hand under the jaw. And you're going to do a movement that's in that left anterior, right posterior plane. So you will quickly move his head, and I'm getting feedback from the software on when I'm in the correct plane of movement. The patient always has their eyes looking towards the screen, but you'll notice the type of head movement is quite different from going left to right. Very good. And I'm still trying to provide different speeds of head movement in this canal plane, and also randomizing when I go up and when I go down. Very good. 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 And if he doesn't know, we can actually wait out the response. I don't need to click a button. Good. Nice work. So the last canal plane that we will look at is actually called the right anterior, left posterior canal plane. And so similarly to the last vertical canals, one hand on top, one hand under the chin, the patient is still looking at that optotype on the screen. Good. And I'm using the software to tell me when I'm in the correct plane of movement. Good. I'm looking for a variety of head speeds. And I also want to randomize the direction, sometimes going a few up and a few down, just so that the patient doesn't expect what's coming next. Good. And I'm using the remote to record the patient's answers as he's saying them out loud.
Good. Sure.
Nice work.